In this video, we are going to talk about function predefined functional interface. Let's see the content of this functional interface first. You can see that in this interface function, it will accept two type arguments. One is T type, one is R type. We have already talked about whenever T type argument type is given, that means it will accept any type of argument type, either it will be wrapper classes or collection classes. And here also given one R type generics. That means which type of argument type we are returning. Whenever R type is mentioned, that means it will return any type of argument type, either it will be collection classes, wrapper classes, or string classes. Now, this function interface has only one abstract method. The name of that abstract method is apply. It will accept any type of input argument. So, the job of this apply abstract method is to take one input argument, provide some sort of an operation, and after that, it will return something. In the previous video of consumer, we have already talked about it, that one argument type it will take, but it will not return anything. But in this functional interface, it will take an input argument and it will do some sort of an operation, and after that it will return an output. Okay, now we have also, we can also see that there is two default method mentioned here. One is compose, another one is and then, and one static method is also mentioned here. The name of that static method is identity function. We are going to talk about all these default method, static method, and the work of this apply abstract method with the help of examples. So let's start. To understand the concept of functional interface, let's write a simple lambda expression. Let's take input argument as a string, and we will return the length of that input argument. So return type should be int, right? So another generic type we will take as integer. Let's keep the name as display. We will take one input argument. I'm keeping the name of that argument will be s, and here we will just return that length of that input argument. Now, we are going to call this apply abstract method, and here I am going to pass one string argument. Let's say string will be welcome to Java 8 tutorials. Now what is going to happen here? After passing this string argument inside apply abstract method, it will return the length of this string. Okay, so let's execute this code to verify our output. The length of this string is 27. So from this example, we can conclude that the job of this functional interface is take one input argument, it will do an operation, and after that it will return the output. And with the help of these two generic types, we can understand what type of input argument it will accept and what type of argument it will return. Here I have given input argument as a string, so it will pass to the string, and I have also mentioned that it will return integer type of argument. So if returned as dot length, it will always return an int, so it returned as an int format. Okay, let's take one more example to understand the concept of this functional interface. In this example, we will keep both input argument and return argument as integer only. We will change the name from display to square. What we will do, we will just return the square of the input value. What I have done here, I am passing one integer argument, and that integer argument will return the square of that value. So let's execute this code. So I have passed 5, right? So the square of 5 is 25. What if I will replace from 5 to 20? So in lambda expression, it will multiply 20 into 20, and the answer will be 400. Now what if I will change return type of argument will be from integer to double, then it will return the value as double. Now, what answer will become? Answer will come as 400.0 in double form. So, from these examples, we can answer the question of this functional interface, that what is the job of this functional interface. The job of this functional interface is take an input argument. It will perform an operation. The input argument can be wrapper classes or collection classes or a string class. It will do an operation, and after that it will return an output according to our requirement. And input argument type and return argument type we will mention inside function generics. Okay, now there are two default methods is also mentioned in this interface class, and the name of this default method is and then and compose default method. To understand the concept of and then and compose default method, we need to take two lambda expression. So let's write a two lambda expression first. In this case, both input and return type of we will keep as integer only. So what I have done here, I have written two different lambda expression. The first, the lambda expression reference name is multiplication. In this multiplication, what I have done, I have taken one input argument, and that input argument will be multiply that value with 4. Another one I have taken again, and the reference of that second one is addition. And what is the job of this? It will add the value with 4 of the input argument. So we will first of all understand the concept of and then default method. We already have seen the job of and then default method in consumer predefined functional interface in the previous video. It will work in the same way as it is worked in the consumer. The job of this and then default method is the addition of two different lambda expression operation. So how we are going to do that? First of all, we are going to write multiplication. The first lambda, the first value you are wanted to execute, you will keep it in the front. Multiplication, and after that and then we will write our second lambda expression. Now what we are going to do, we will pass this addition dot dot apply, and here addition dot apply, and here I am going to pass one value name, just say 3 I am passing here. What will be the output? So I have used and then operation in addition. So what it will do first of all, it will execute here. So input will be 3 into 4 12, and after that second, and then after that I pass the second operation. What is the job here? 12 plus 4 16 it will show as a result. 16 is the result. We have written like this. There is also another way to write and then default method. That is, instead of writing like this, we can also write, now what we will do, addition dot multiplication dot and then that addition dot apply 3. Now the first operation you wanted to execute, you will keep in the first. After that you will use the default method, and the second operation you wanted to execute, you will keep it in the last. So after that you have passed an apply abstract method. So what I have done here, so I have passed an apply method input argument as 3. So what is going to happen here? First of all, it will execute like multiply dot apply 3. So what will be the output? 3 into 4, and the output will pass into the second operation. What is the second operation? Addition. Here input will be passed as the 12. Here input will be passed as a 12 because that is the result of the multiplication lambda expression operation. Now answer will be 12 plus 4, answer will be 16. It will be exactly same the way it worked with the previous example, 16. Now there is one more default method is there, and that default method is compose. Let's see the job of a compose default method. Compose default method job is also same. It will add two different lambda expression operation with one just tiny difference. That is, in and then default method, first value it will going to execute first, after that second one. In compose default method, the last value it will be going to execute first, and after that first value. What does that mean? Let's change from and then to compose here first. Now, what I've told you about compose default method, it will also add two different operation, but the last lambda expression is going to execute first, and after that the first one. So in that means 3 plus 4 is 7, 7 into 4, 28. Here I will change the name, one display 1 and display 2. In and then default method answer will be 16, and compose default method answer will be 28. 16 and the second one is 28. How it happens? In and then default method, first operation it will going to execute, and after that the second one. In the compose default method, the last operation is going to execute first, and then after that the first one will be the last. So another example, instead of 3 we will take 5 as an input. Now what is going to happen? In and then default method, multiplication is the first, so input will go here first. So 5 into 4, 20. After that the 20 will pass as an input in addition operation. So 20 plus 4 is 24. So here answer will be in and then default method is 24. How it is going to happen? First 5 into 4, answer will be 20, and then this 20 will pass inside additional lambda expression operation. So 20 plus 4, so final result we will get as 24. Now in compose default method, what will happen? First of all, addition is going to happen. So 5 plus 4 is 9, then after that multiplication will pass as in that whatever the output we have getting in addition, it will pass into multiplication. So 9 is the output of addition, so it will take an input as a 9. So 9 into 4 is 36. Let's execute this code to verify our output. In display 1 it will show 24, and display 2 it will show 36. So we understood the job of and then and compose default method. Now there is one static method is also given in this functional interface. The name of that static method is identity function. Let's understand this identity static function with the help of an example. Let's say I will pass and write an SOP here. Function.identity.apply. Here I will pass input as a 100. Then I told you that identity will only return an input argument. So input I have provided 100, then it will display as 100 only. Now what if input I will provide is a string? I will write only Java 8. So again it will display as identity Java 8. So we understood the job of a identity static method also. It will just return the input argument. There are some functional interfaces are also available in Java 8 whose works are similar to this functional interface. Those functional interfaces are by function. In function we have taken only one input type of an argument, and after that it will return anything. But what if I wanted to pass two input argument instead of one, then in that scenario we will take as by function functional interface. Let's see the content of this by function functional interface. We can see that it will take two input type of argument, and after that it will return same thing it was written in the apply abstract method. We can see that instead of one, it will take two input argument and it will return, and it will, after doing some sort of an operation, it will return an output. Now in this by functional interface, only one default method is there, and the name of that default method is and then. But what if you already know what type of input argument we are going to accept? Let's say you know that then you need only in type of input argument you need to accept in this project. In that scenario, we can use int function functional interface. In this interface, we can see that it will accept only int value, nothing else, and we can return any type of type argument after doing an operation. But what if instead of int, if you wanted to take double, then instead of int function, we will use double function predefined functional interface. So now here, instead of taking int value, now we are taking as double value. What if instead of double, if you want long, then instead of doing double function, we will take long function, functional interface. So in this video, what are the things we learned? We learned about functional interface and their contents inside. Functional interface has one apply abstract method that will take one T type of argument, and it will perform an operation, and after that it will return R type of, and then it will return an output. And in this functional interface has two default method. The name of the default method is and then and compose. Job of and then and compose default method is same. The only difference is that and then default method will execute the first lambda expression and the second one in the last, and the compose default method will execute the second lambda operation first and the first one in the last. After that, we have also seen about the job of a identity function static method. It will only return an input argument, and there are some predefined functional interfaces like by function, int function, long function, double function, which those works are similar to that functional interface. The difference between function and by function is, in function we will take only one input argument, in by function we will take two type of input argument, and also in by function we don't have composed and identity function methods. Now int function, double function, long function. In int function, double function and long function, if we are completely fixed that we will take input value as int only, long only or double only, then in that scenario we are going to use this functional interface. In this functional interfaces, we don't have any default method, we don't have any static methods. So guys, this is the end of this video tutorial. In the next video, we are going to talk about supplier predefined functional interface. So keep watching Java 8 tutorials. Thank you.